Now we go back to what I was saying. Those teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you look at them carefully, you will find he spoke about how when a person passes away, his deeds are cut off, besides a few. Those are the ones I'm interested in today, because we're talking of the legacy of a Muslim. And do you know, all of those deeds are connected to how you have benefited others. All of those deeds. Let's take a look at the first hadith. إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمَ إِنْ قَطَعَ عَنْهُ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثِ. If a person, a human being, passes away, his deeds are cut off besides three. What are those three? Knowledge that he has left. We spoke about knowledge that he has left behind, which means you taught someone something. In another narration, it speaks about how you have bequeathed a mushaf, a Quran. You gave someone something beneficial. Ilmun yuntafa'u bih, knowledge that is being benefited from, whether you taught it or you spread it, or you were one of the chain of people who caused that knowledge to be spread. You are not a knowledgeable person, but you sponsored some people for their knowledge, or you brought people to teach others, or you were paying the salaries of someone, or you were reaching out to those with knowledge in order to promote their teachings, or you used to forward good lectures to your friends and to your those whom you could, or you used to do whatever it was, but you were not knowledgeable, but you were in that chain. You also get the reward. That reward is not taken from others, it's given to you. That's it. Equal. Then, sadaqatun jariyah, it means any charity where the benefit of that charity lives beyond your own life. It's called a sadaqatun jariyah. If my life was 70 years, may Allah grant us healthy lives, may He take us away when He is pleased with us at whatever age He chooses. If your life is 70 years and you have done something very good, you planted a tree. This is also from the hadith, أو غرس شجران. It's from another narration, but it's included in this. You planted a tree and the tree lived for 200 years and it benefited people with fruit and with shade. You get a reward beyond your 70 for another 130 years. The day the tree is gone, your reward grinds to a halt. But a tree is such that at times, if that tree has produced seeds and those seeds were planted by someone else, you have a full reward of what another person did, because they could have only done it because you did what you did and the seeds came through there. Allahu Akbar. That's the beauty of Allah. That's why أو غرس شجران is in the hadith. In particular, it is mentioned. And the Prophet ﷺ speaks about so many different things. Ajra Naharan. You know what Ajra Naharan means? A person who made a river so that people could benefit from the water, whether it is rainwater or water coming from a lake or the sea or whatever. The one who channeled these lakes or rivers, the rivers, will get a full reward for anyone who benefited from it. Notice one thing. This aspect is not direct knowledge. Direct knowledge is one. We spoke about it already. This is benefiting humankind. If you leave anything that benefits humankind, it is also a great legacy.